Hey everybody, Austin back again with another Let's Play video. This time it's going to be Battle Monsters for the Sega Saturn. And it's actually the Japanese version of Battle Monsters, so neither one of us is going to have any idea of what's going on as we're playing through this game. I actually picked up the Japanese version last week at a local game shop, super cheap. It was like $3 for a complete in-box copy and everything. I actually had the United States version of this about last year, but I ended up selling it, and the original plan was to do a Let's Play or a long play on that version of the game, so you could read the story and all that kind of stuff, but I ended up getting rid of it. I had a big downsizing, and it was one of the games I got rid of. And I've always still kind of wanted to do a Let's Play on it, but I haven't wanted to shell out like the 10 or 15 bucks it costs to get this game. I mean, I don't think this is a terrible game. I just don't think it's a great game either. I mean, it's actually got some kind of fun gameplay. I like how the graphics look, and I like the scaling and the scrolling and the backgrounds and things like that. But it's kind of cheesy at the same time. If you look in the instruction manual in this game, there's actually some really sweet hand-drawn art, some really cool character designs, but for some reason, in the main game itself, they decided to go for a digitized look. They used real actors, they used claymation on for certain characters, and it's so bad. Like, why are these two completely, like, opposing styles? You got this really cool hand-drawn style that you could have used as the main characters in the game, but you went with this digitized style instead, and it just... Battle Monsters had so much potential, I think, to be one of the better two-dimensional fighting games of the era, but it kind of falls flat in its face, partially because of that guy. Yeah, you yell, man. You go. Awesome. There's one guy that's like a bird character, and he's just kind of like, the mask looks like a trash bag on his head. It's so bad, but yeah, that's one of the main reasons why I didn't really want to invest in the American version again. I mean, to pay 15 bucks to get a nice complete copy for this, I mean, no, I could be spending my money on better things. But when I saw the Japanese version for $3, I was like, oh, hell yes, I'll pay $3 for it because it's complete. It's complete. It's nice. I don't mind it being in my collection when I've only paid, you know, for less than a burger at McDonald's for it. So, yeah. I was also kind of hoping that the Japanese version would have some differences for the better, but actually it doesn't really. Aside from some of the Japanese text, from what I can tell, everything else is identical. So, let's go ahead and get into the game, but first let's go to the options screen so you can kind of see what that's like. Loading. Please wait. Waiting. I love it when you have to wait for option screens. That's awesome, right? So basically, you've got a bunch of different things here. You've got your difficulty modes, and we're going to be leaving it on normal because I don't feel like getting my ass handed to me because I don't really know this game that well. And I'll go into more of that later as we progress throughout this video. We get the timer. I should turn off, but I'm going to go ahead and leave it on. Match point is 2. You can go up to 3. So we'll do best 2 out of 3. And then you got controls. You get A is punch, B is kick, C is appeal. I think appeal is like taunt. Pressing up jumps just like in any other fighting games, but you can also use the X, Y, and Z buttons to do that. You can dash left or right by pressing the L or R buttons, kind of like in Guilty Gear, but you can also do that by just double tapping in either direction as well. I prefer to double tap just because that's how I did it in Guilty Gear, so... Stereo and mono, doesn't really matter, and you got sound tests and whatnot. So we'll go ahead and just exit, get back to the main screen. Overall, I think this game is actually pretty simplistic. I mean, you've got punch, you've got kick, and you've got a taunt button. That's it. Not a whole lot to the game. You do have your fireballs and so forth, like in Street Fighter, Mortal Kombat. And you do have the potential to juggle a very, very minimal amount. Like, you can knock somebody into the air, toss a fireball, and they'll get hit by it once, kind of like in Street Fighter. So, all right, here are our characters, guys. There's you know, the sprites actually don't look that bad. It looks like, you know, it's rendered decently enough, considering this was like 1995 or something like that. But you know, they're just so cheesy. Like, this guy, that's the guy I was telling you about, the bird guy. It's like, what the hell is that? Like, why? Why? Now, if he was hand-drawn, he looked like demonic, he had horns coming out of his head, that would be pretty badass. But instead, he looks like a dude wearing, like, spirit Halloween costume slippers. Ugh. And that dude, seriously, they couldn't even put gloves on him? His hands are, like, normal skin tone, but his face is completely white. They couldn't have put white gloves on him? What? Oh my god. She at least looks somewhat legit, because she obviously doesn't have a real snake on her. That's obviously fake. And she looks cooler. But she still looks kind of cheesy. That's really cheesy, but it's better than the other efforts, if you ask me. The bottom is at least tacked on, a little bit different. Not some dude in slippers or some guy that's not even wearing gloves that match his skin tone. Unless he's like Michael Jackson or something. I don't know. Could be. And this guy, anyway, I'm not going to try to make fun of this game because really I'm bad at making fun of games. So I'm going to go ahead and just pick this chick. She's actually the main character I know in this game. Haven't played it too much, so I don't know the other characters, but I know how to play as her. And when you play it by yourself, you basically try to get to the end of the game. And it's got this world map like some other single-player fighting games did back in the day. It's actually kind of reminiscent of Shaq Fu now that I think about it. Then you get this, tells you what battlefield you're going to. And then you get into it, just like a regular fighting game. So, now Battle Monsters actually has some things that are really cool about it. Like, just, I like the backgrounds in this game. I love how it scales in and out. I've always loved that about, certain games back in the day. The scrolling playfield on the bottom is kind of cool. And when you zoom up close, or I'm sorry, when you get close, you actually zoom up close. It's pretty cool. I also like the life bar in the bottom, the sort of candles. Kind of cool stuff. The candles go down as you get hit. So, pretty cool. But, some of the other things, like, again, the characters are just really cheesy. So, Battle Monsters is really hit or miss. I'm sorry, hit and miss. But, the gameplay is a little button mashy as well. Like, if I just keep mashing my kick button, I literally just keep going crazy like that. And really, the game shouldn't have been designed like that. This is starting to sound more like a review than an actual Let's Play. But the same thing with the punch button. If I just keep mashing punch, I just kind of beat the crap out of my opponent, provided they don't beat the crap out of me first. See? So, like in other fighting games, though, you've got, special moves, fireballs, etc. This chick has this really annoying sounding sort of zapper bolt thing. It's actually really good. It's what you're going to see me doing throughout this playthrough is kind of playing safe, tossing off fireballs left and right. She's got one that can go down. She's got one that can go up. Really, really useful. And if you can actually get the character into like a juggle or something, which I'm not going to try to demonstrate now because my life is low, you can actually knock him into the air and then hit him with the fireball. Oh. And it actually does decent damage. I think it takes away almost a full candle, which is not too bad. So, and like in games like Guilty Gear, you can actually kind of just sort of jump cancel your way into it. You can literally do it like right away. Kind of like that. Tap up and quickly do the fireball motion to do it. And you can do it literally right off the ground. It's pretty cool. Not really useful for that one, but there you go. There's a small juggle. Not really a juggle, but just the 1-2 punch. Getting that free hit in the air. Oh, had a chance to do it again, but I mashed the freaking kick button way too many times. I didn't really feel good about that win. I won by mashing the punch button. That never feels good in a fighting game to me. Oh boy, this is gonna be a long let's play. I already don't feel like playing this game anymore. The subtle music's kind of catchy though. Not this music track though. But I actually kind of do like some of the music in this game. It's kind of like poorly produced some of its sounds. Like this track especially is just awful. But like the main character select screen, etc. I actually kind of like that. I you know, it's simple, but it works. It's kind of memorable. Get it stuck in my head occasionally. Did he really just like growl like he had too much food in his stomach? Really? Now I'm pretty sure you've got super moves in this game. Boy, I have no idea how to do them. I remember looking in the American version last year trying to figure out how to do moves. I was like drinking Heineken one night, trying to, you know, get tipsy enough to really enjoy this game. Looking through the instruction manual and just being really confused by how the moves were shown in the manual. Like, they actually kind of look like normal fighting game moves, but whenever you tried to do them, you just could not do them. And I could pretty much do any move I've ever come across in just about any fighting game I've ever played. So it's not like it's ever been a problem for me. You know, I played fighting games competitively for a little while, so it's not as competitively as others, but more competitively than the average person, you know. Went to a few tournaments and so forth, and you know, like, so that shouldn't be a problem for me, but I just could not do some of the moves in this game. Oh look, there's one, I just figured it out, apparently. Maybe that's what that special button is for. How did I do that? Probably gotta get my meter back up. That throw does a lot of damage. Oh, ugh! Could have got a free fireball on him, but you gotta really be careful about not mashing the punchy kick buttons a second or third time, because you'll just do a quick string and completely screw up what you were trying to do. In that case, what would have been ideal is for me to just kick him once, launch him in the air, and then shoot a fireball. Chili and pepper. Two free hits, basically. I forgot to mention you can double jump in this game, so that's also pretty cool. The game definitely had some cool things in it, like being able to double jump, being able to shoot up and down, being able to do fireballs in the air. That was stuff that you didn't see all that often until games like Guilty Gear, you know, really faster paced fighting games like that. I kind of wonder if like some of the guys that made this went on to like Arc System Works or something and actually worked on Guilty Gear, because some of the concepts you find in this game are also in games like that, and those are much newer fighting games. Well, actually not that much newer, because the original Guilty Gear came out in, I think it was 98, so it was only a couple years after this one, when you think about it. I mean, this game definitely had some potential. I think the controls could have been much tighter. I think there could have been much less of a cheese factor. That definitely would have helped it a lot. That would have helped it hold up at least a little bit better. I mean, even if they kept the gameplay the same, graphics alone can allow games to hold up better than others, depending on how the graphics are. And had everything been hand-drawn in this game, I think it would have worked a lot better. Especially if, you know, all the visuals were hand-drawn as well, and not sort of pseudo-digitized. Because I think, like Guardian Heroes, or like good pixel art or something. Guardian Heroes, the scaling still works pretty well because it's just blocks, you know? It's like, it's solid pixel art. But, here, it's like you can tell they kind of digitized like bushes and like they plastered them into the background. And in some cases, it looks all right, but other cases, it doesn't. And all right, Magic Factory. There's no R in there. It's just F-A-C-T-R-Y. Factory. Factory. Tree. Factry. Factory? Factry. This is one of those stages where you can actually get up on these platforms, which is kind of cool. Because my character can't even jump that high. Okay, so you can actually use your sort of taunt for a special attack. I did it twice, but now it's not working. What the hell? There we go. Okay. Yeah. I believe there was another move I had I was doing yesterday. Alright. Gotta actually make some hits because, the time ran out. That's why I wanted to make some hits. I'm too busy experimenting. Too much experimentation, not enough ass kickage. Really going head first on these guys is not really wise from what I can tell. How this game would be in two-player mode, if it would be any fun or if it would be just stupid. Or there we go, nice little combo. Do you know, I don't know, I've never played this game in two-player mode as far as I'm aware. If I have, it was a long time ago, back in the 90s, and I just completely forgot, probably for good reason. But I don't know, I wonder if this game would have greater redeeming value if it's, you know, in the single player, not the single player, I'm sorry, but have a greater redeeming value in the two player mode, if it's actually maybe kind of fun. A little bit like a Smash Brothers or something like that, although obviously not nearly as good, because Smash Brothers was pretty varied. Lots of moves per character, just a lot of fun to play, even though it's can be very button mashy as well, but there is a very serious competitive scene for that game though, so obviously people do take that one seriously. So is he the only guy that can get up on those? Because I can't get up on there at all. At least hit him one or two more times because time's gonna run out. I need to make sure I win. There you go.
Hi.
She goes, hi. Like, hi, or do you want to get high? Which is it, girl? I mean, like, which one? Hi. Hi. Hi, oh, hi, what the f- This game is so retarded. Oh, okay, down and your taunt does that. That is pretty cool. Alright, alright. More kudos to Battle Monsters, I think, maybe. That did a lot of damage. And this is why you play it safe. Bad. It almost sounded like they were using like a Tarzan sample and then they just cut it off at the very end. So watch out for those copyright enforcement agencies. They're out there. You know, the game's like almost 20 years old. I'm sure some lawyers would still find a way to sue. You used a half-Tarzan sample in an obscure Sega Saturn game that nobody ever played to almost 20 years ago. You won $1 million for your wrongdoing. In the state of affairs today in 2013, I'm sure that's definitely possible. Kind of on a similar subject, and like actually a real subject, Killer Instinct, pretty popular fighting game in the mid-90s, is now mostly in Microsoft's hands as far as I'm aware. However, in the last year or two, I think, they went to try to renew, I guess, the trademark on it or something like that, or the copyright, or and the intellectual properties. I don't know how it all works. But apparently they weren't able to renew the Killer Instinct name, because a book from 2005 had the same name. I'm just like, what the fuck? Killer Instinct's been around since 1994. Damn it, 1994. How does a book from 2005 take precedence over that? It's just, I don't even understand how that stuff works. It's stupid if there will never be a Killer Instinct game again, despite the fans wanting it, because some stupid-ass book that probably nobody's ever read has the same title. In reality, the book should have been, you know, denied, like, whatever it's supposed to go through for having the same name, and it's, I don't understand how that stuff works. It just sounds stupid to me. You know what else is stupid? It's me standing back and just shooting fireballs across the screen and letting the time run out. That is just really retarded. But hey, it's working. As you can tell, getting up close to these enemies is actually really risky. I mean, what I could be doing is trying to block and then counterattacking, but that doesn't seem to actually be working out all that well. This guy especially, I remember last night I was playing, I literally just sat back and fireballed my way, and it worked. So I'm just gonna keep doing it. Why are you getting hit by it? Hold back, dude! Just hold back! That's what I tell, like, somebody I was playing against. I actually get kind of annoyed when I play against people and they don't know how to block, or they don't... I ended up, like, telling them how to play. Like, dude, hold back. Cause, like, I feel bad. It's like, I shouldn't feel bad because you don't know how to play or don't know the basics of a fighting game. But, I don't know. If I ever play like a real newbie, I'll just be like, dude, hold back, press this, do that. Okay, you got it? Okay, now play. I'm kind of a dick in that regard, but I don't... That's just how I am, I guess. I like having some kind of a challenge. I don't like just wrecking people and then walking around telling everybody how good I am. I'm not that kind of person. I like to have some kind of challenge, and I like the matches to be fair. As fair as they could be, you know? which is why when I do play fighting games these days, if it's ever, I don't really play that many. Actually, not really at all. I like to only play it with people that I know are, like, pretty good at them, so... If I play, like, Mortal Kombat on Xbox Live or something like that, I will... I think there's an option where you can basically pick to play against players that are, like, rated better than you. And that'll be, like, the only way I play, typically. Because I don't like finding that newbie guy. Kind of just wasted my time, like, wrecking a newbie guy. It's just not any fun, and I feel bad because I probably made the guy never want to play a fighting game again. You know, and that's kind of how I look at it. Bam, 1-2 combo. That was really bad, and I'm sure this Let's Play is just terrible. I mean, I'm just... And every time I do it, she goes, boo, boo, boo. It's like, why are you making that sound? Please stop. Oh, the Hungry Cave. This is actually kind of a cool level. It's interesting. It's actually got ring outs. And I'll probably be able to ring out this guy just by shooting fireballs at him over and over again. That's what I did last night. And he goes down. But he doesn't get chomped on because I already killed him. But basically, there's like some big-ass Venus flytraps down there. And if you fall down, it's like a ring out and Virtue Fighter or something like that. And you basically lose in one hit. And I think... Is this like apparently the Shang Tsung of the game? He can like... There you go. Bam. Kind of cool, but not really. But that is one of the high points of this game, is how the arenas are mixed up a little bit. Like, you've got arenas that it's just straight up fighting game, you move left and right. You got other arenas where you can get ring outs. And you got other arenas where you can, it's like Smash Brothers, you get different platforms and things like that. So, I mean, this game definitely had, you know, some of its ideas in the right place. But the art style, some of the action, the kind of the button mashy nature. It's really tough to have, like, a good control over this game. Not that I practiced it a whole lot. I'm sure if I played it for hours and hours, I'd be much more precise with it, so... Man, that chick is just... She's got some big moves that can do a lot of damage. Okay, so that's not good. You don't want to just mash on the third attack on her kick motion, because they'll block it and then basically get a free hit. Time's out. I wonder what the timer is, if it's like... 60 seconds? It's gotta be 60, because that doesn't feel like, it definitely did not feel like a 90-second match. How do they do that? Three hits? Yes, I will take it. Okay, I've got how to do that. Alright. Hey, I found out a new move! It's half circle back and then quarter circle back down to the center. Kind of a weird way to do a move, but hey, like, if that launches into the air like that, that gives me the opportunity to get another free fireball off. Hi. Keep missing it. Time's almost out, I just don't want to get hit again. This is kind of pathetic how I'm just like timing out the game. It doesn't feel good to win like that, but I don't feel like I have control over the game like I do in like a Mortal Kombat or a Street Fighter or a Guilty Gear or a Killer Instinct or something like that. Because the game's so button mashy, like it's... And this chick last night, I remember all I was doing was the fireball thing. The stage kind of has a cool gimmick, though. It's got these, rocks. Ooh. It's supposed to. Get back over here. There's gotta be a rock over here. There you go. There we go. Big rock up there. It takes a ton of life off when it actually hits you. It takes like 3/4 of your health. It's actually pretty crazy. So the goal is to try to hit your opponent with it, because that's the great equalizer. Let's use it on this side this time. Oh yeah, you got the stalactites or whatever the hell they're called. Jesus. 4 hits. Not only does it do 4 hits, it takes away almost half your life. You know what I'm gonna do? Is spam you with fireballs! Yeah! Oh man, why am I even playing this game? It sounded like a really good idea when I came into this, but now I'm rethinking that proposition. Oh, what the fuck? Come on, man. That was crap. Yes, I will continue. I got this far. I'm not going to stop now. She's making a really annoying sound whenever she gets hit. She goes, yeah! My voice is going on. I'm having a hard time mimicking her crappier voice. Oh, I don't think so. Oh! I got hit by the top of it. Didn't take that much life away, which is good. I don't even want to get close to her because of crap like that. Dare you to transform again. Come on. Oh yeah. Guys, we can do this. There, it hit her. Ooh, and that hit me. Jeez, frame rate just totally sped up. That was like crazy. That's so bad. Hi. I gotta track down like the creators of this game. Mirror match. I gotta track down like the creators of this game and see like where they went on to when they made future games. Okay. Let's have a tappy match. Well, that was useless, lady. She just flew right up into the sky. Time over. They both said it at the same time. this is so bad. Oh, man. Well, you know, guys, after about 38 minutes of playing this game, according to my computer screen, this isn't going to be one of the most proud Let's Plays I've ever done. Definitely not. I'm actually kind of bored just doing this Let's Play, which is kind of a first. I don't think I've ever done a Let's Play where I just have not really wanted to do it, like... I mean, this is just kind of different than usual. I mean, usually I don't play really bad games for Let's Plays. I play games I like for Let's Plays, and I can talk about a lot and, you know, things like that. This game, on the other hand, wow, it's definitely, you know, the first of its kind in terms of me doing Let's Plays. Battlefield on the Palm. This guy. Is he really called Strawberry Jam? Are you serious? S Jam? Oh. Strawberry Jam! He doesn't even look like freaking strawberries or jam! You can just stay down there, man. Are you serious? Falling down brings him back up? Stay down there. Oh, that's awful. Strawberry jam. Well, he's definitely powerful, that's for sure. Yeah, let's fall down. It's like asteroids, except we're not playing asteroids. You go outside one edge of the screen, you come back on the other. Battle Strawberry Jam. Get your hands wet and sticky with some strawberry jam. Why the hell do they call him strawberry jam? Unless it's actually something else and it went by so quickly, it doesn't actually say strawberry, it says like, strawberry something, I have no idea. Ow, ow. It's gonna leave a mark. A big red mark. He's really easy for looking as menacing as he does. About as menacing as a poorly animated claymation figure can. I think Primal Rage gets flack these days for being like claymation, but the fact of the matter is that game animated really well. Every character had a ton of frames of animation. So I think Primal Rage has always looked pretty good, and I think it still looks pretty good today, because it's just got, there's so many frames. Like, those guys really put a lot of work into making those digitized characters look really, really cool. Kind of really real, too. This game, on the other hand, oh my god. This game is just, Really? I'm just gonna sit back here just like every other fight. Okay, maybe I can't do that. He's got big long range fireballs just like I do. Ah, okay. Oh, I can do that move in the air too. That's pleasant. Characters seem really unbalanced too. Like, that guy seems like a very projectile heavy character. He's probably one of the broken characters in the game. And look at that! Oh, draw. Do we both get one? I hope we both get one. Oh, neither one of us gets one. You gotta do it all over again? That is crap. Really? Okay, I'll take it. He was being really annoying the last match, so I'll take an easy win this time. I kind of want to just get this over. It's 45 minutes. Wow, 45 minutes of Battle Monsters. Just thinking about that is making my, my brain hurt. Can't believe I've actually done this. Attacking straight up definitely feels alright. I mean, like, when you actually connect a hit, you're like, oh, sweet, I got a hit. And it, but it actually connecting and knocking them up is kind of a crapshoot. But once it actually does connect and they go flying up, it feels pretty good. But it's so hard to actually get the hit off on a computer opponent. It's just not worth going for it. If you're trying to go for like a one credit clear or something, you could fireball all the way. I forgot, is there a last boss in this game, or is it just straight to the end? I don't remember. Of course, it's in Japanese, because we're playing the Japanese version, so I have no idea what it's saying. I thought there was a final boss. This might be it. Yeah. Yeah, because I did beat this game back last year. Actually, I think if I remember correctly, this guy was a bit of a pain in the ass. You seriously gotta beat him like 5 times? Oh, that doesn't look good. Attacking, dude. I'm going all the way across the other side of the screen. He's like kicking. You trying to do your fireball and not getting it off properly, dude? Computer opponent, you. Whoa. Yay. I got an easy win on the last boss. I thought he had different forms. Yeah. Kind of like the Eternal Champion on Eternal Champions. He's got a bunch of different forms. That's a game I kind of wish they kept going on with. That was a cool series. Especially the Sega CD one. Oh, man. And I think the last boss fight was just crazy in that game. I think he literally had like 8 forms or something like that. And then you have the Dark Eternal Champion, which I think I had like the same amount. It was just crazy. Really? Really, man? No challenge. I mean, I'll take no challenge, because I kind of just want to get this Let's Play over with. And if you guys are still watching, I salute you, because I don't know why you're still watching this video. I've been going, two, 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 the whole video, and you guys are like, wow, this is amazing. You're probably not. I mean, if you are, then I tip my hat off to you, but... Oh, he's like invisible this time. Sort of. I can see an outline. Wow, do projectiles not even work? No? I just realized in the background they pasted the same characters over and over. You can see the Frankenstein guy like 8 times back there. What the hell, man? Really? This form of the final boss is kind of annoying. Now the fireball thing's actually working, so I'll take that too. It's really sad to get a time over on every form. get up close and they just block everything. You really have to use projectiles in this game to get anywhere. It's just... the AI is not all that good. They run into your fireballs when they're all the way across the screen, but... you can't hit them with your fists when you're right next to them. It's just, Alright guys, well that's Battle Monsters. That's the end of the game, I'm pretty sure. Unfortunately, we're not going to be able to read what the credits say, but you might be able to find other Let's Plays on YouTube or find screenshots on the web that actually, you know, show what the text actually says. Definitely a better use of the live action shots. It doesn't look as bad as the rest of the game does. They definitely touched up those shots. I wonder what it looks like for the other characters in the game, but I would definitely not would not have the patience to go through and do the entire game again with every other character. Screw that. One character is enough. If anybody else has completed this game, if you're actually still watching, if you are, I don't know why, but if anybody else has completed this game, you know, let me know. I'd really be interested to hear your thoughts on this game. I mean, as I've said plenty of times in this video, I think Battle Monsters is really hit or miss. It had a lot of potential, but it falls short in a lot of areas. I mean, the digitized graphics alone is definitely does not hold up all that well. The scaling is pretty cool though, and the arenas are kind of cool. The gameplay had promise. You know, you can double jump, you can do fireballs in the air, you can sort of get quick 1-2 combos, launch them into the air, do a quick fireball. That type of stuff is pretty cool, and that definitely helps longevity in a fighting game, but everything else is just kind of like the controls. It's tough to feel like you're fully in control in this game. Like, you accidentally mash your kick button more than once, then you automatically do a quick string of hits. It's just, it's button mashing in that regard. So, I don't know. The voiceovers are pretty crappy as well. And, yeah. So with that, guys, I'm going to go ahead and wrap up this video. As usual, I appreciate you watching. If you're new to my channel, feel free to subscribe. I've got more content on the way. And I'll be back with some more casual reviews and Let's Plays sometime soon. So until next time, guys, take care.